Right, a very good afternoon to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here today. At the onset, let me thank the Quality Council of India and the Dilsha Award Committee for having us here today. We are a multi-speciality dental setup right here in New Delhi, and that's why we stuck to our forte when we were trying to go for a case presentation or a study. We stuck to the fact that what effects the kind of little work we do for our patients, what kind of effect it does, like the dental aesthetics, what impact it provides on the psychosocial well-being and self-confidence of our patients. Patients who travel across the globe to reach us from all over the world. We treat patients from more than 20 to 25 countries, and they come to treat their dental disabilities in one form of the other. It's just that sometimes we feel that this is such a little work, and why do people feel about the fact of having a dental treatment done? But trust me, ask those people who are getting this work done, it means a lot to them. Thereby, coming to our problem statement, that if somebody is embarrassed about this teeth, or they find it as a dental disability, what could be the various reasons that they are not likely to smile? And for us, smiling was the biggest gift that we can give back to the society. The objective, we never wanted anybody to have, when they're laughing or smiling, they should have a hand on their teeth and trying to be a little embarrassed about the fact that they don't have the best set of teeth, what they deserve. So we wanted to do a little study about how do various individuals, they perceive the level of satisfaction when they smile. It had a straight approach. When we were really surprised when we were doing this study, let me just get back to you on what we got, the findings out of it. It was really surprising. We did a short term, about 6 to 7 months of study from the various patients who were treated at our center. We went for about 250 to 260 respondents were contacted to go for this kind of a survey. This survey was a PIDAQ survey, which was the lead article of our study. And 0, when the patient doesn't like the smile. 1, maybe they like the smile. Or 2, yes, they definitely like the smile. So we wanted to see what kind of work we are doing and whether we are able to change their psychosocial backdrop. The questionnaire which was sent to the patients was a very simple one. Dental self, it included a few components. I've just, for the paucity of time, I've just included the headings. The first heading was the dental self-confidence. The second was the social impact. Third was the psychological impact. And fourth was the aesthetic concern. And we wanted to do a qualitative and a quantitative analysis for this. As we came to the discussion, out of respondents, about 62 of them responded for the whole survey, which was still a decent figure, giving by means of the number of respondents we contacted for. The results and implementations, we were very nice to see that individual perceived level of satisfaction was really changed when we were trying to do the quality work for our patients. What were our limitations? The limitations were not many, but definitely the sample size. As we grow more and more in our practice, as we take more and more time to contact our patients and to let them, encourage them to be a part of this survey, the sample size was definitely a little one. Lack of available data, there was no earlier study before. It was first time in India it was done like this. Lack of proper research, prior research, nothing was, except for our lead article, didn't have much of it. Limitations of self-reporting data, we understand the limitation of that. What was the impact? The impact was great. It definitely showed us how it impacted directly on the self-confidence of the patient, especially when they have a nice and bright smile. See, all of you don't mind when I share something nice, all of you would love to laugh and show, express your happiness onto it. It is just a gesture that yes, I am pretty confident and well placed at peace with myself, that yes, I'm able to smile the way or laugh the way I want to. Trust me, a lot of time being a part of a dental disabled person, they are not able to do that. It had the improved level of dental hygiene. What patients were, they were very encouraged to go ahead and do that. Awareness about cosmetic cosmetic dental procedures, confidence level, perception, everything was much better. It helped the clinic because we are a part of the one of the leading for dental tourism in the country. It definitely helped when we were showcasing our cases on our website. And most importantly, what I should say was the positivity that yes, after the treatment, the kind of patient's attitude was there. The positivity was what it exuberated. You get a lot of compliments back from the patient. They use a lot of social media to represent you back with the means of Facebook or WhatsApp or a Twitter handle or Instagram, and they try to show their gratitude when these kind of work are done and they are happy about it. In conclusion, what I should say today, we stand proud because we have dedicated the recently going on, ongoing, in fact, it's about to conclude now, the Rio Olympic Games, and it was the true women power which actually paved the way today for us to be proud in front of the whole world standing. And when, let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that when we do these kind of work which creates a lot of happiness for our patients, it is again a true woman power in our setup. The lady behind who has done all this kind of work, one of the best cosmetic dentists in the country, Dr. Sween Kathuria, who is here with us, that's her work, that what you're trying to see today. And for us, it was a great pleasure and honor as a part of our team to do this kind of work in our setup and do this kind of study.